Hey, thank you so much for joining my YouTube channel. Of course, I want to invite you to subscribe because it's fantastic. And we're continuing our series called The Focus Factor. I think it's really important, especially at the beginning of the year, to think about focus. And one thing to help you with your focus is to get my new book called Hey God, Can We Talk? Oh my goodness. Hop on the website, heygodbook.com. And you can see what's this all about and see some really cool, not just content, but also potential for how you can apply this book. Super, super helpful. Actually, it's probably my favorite book that I've written so far. And almost, it kind of almost wrote itself. Really, really powerful. And as we think about focus, focus is a big deal, right? I mean, where you go is determined by your focus. And so I learned this lesson. One of the things that was very powerful to me, I had this experience before I had kids that I took a mountain bike lesson. And here I live in Colorado, so I was up in the summertime up at one of the ski resorts. And what they did was this, they gave you these lessons on how to ride a mountain bike, single track, like down a mountain. And you put your bike on the back of the ski lift. They take you up, and you get your bike off at the top of the ski lift. And then they help you kind of work your way down on this single track, right? Single track. So I'm in this group, and the instructor is telling us, you know, do this and giving us techniques and all this stuff. And we're coming down the mountain, and there's a really, it's kind of steep. And there's a hairpin curve. And there's a couple people in front of me on their bikes, and I can hear the instructor yelling, look past the curve. And the first guy in the line, he's yelling, look past the curve, look. And it's really, it's coming quick, because it's a steep incline. And the guy, for whatever reason, he braked, you know, he did his brakes, and he did them wrong, so he locked up his front tire, which means that he flipped over the back tire, and he went flying off, flying off into the trees, didn't make the hairpin curve. The second person, the instructor, look past the curve, look past, and the second one's coming up. You can tell the second one starts to freeze in the curve and locks up and doesn't, like just gets too fixated on the curve and just flies off the trail into the trees on their bike. I'm the next one, right? So I'm like, ugh. And the instructor's, look past the curve, look past the curve. And I'm like, that doesn't make any sense. You know, because when I learn to drive, you always look at where you're going. Because if you don't look where you're going, you're going to hit something. But the instructor, look past the curve. And I'm like, you know, and I'm doing this in my head. And so finally, I just listened. I was like, look. And when I looked, it was interesting because where I looked is where my bike went. And I made that sharp curve. I made the hairpin curve and didn't crash and burn in the curve. And I want to say to you today that where you look is where you will go. And if you look at crisis, if you look at storms, if you look at whatever catastrophes, it gets in your soul and it affects not only your direction, but also your decisions. And I want you to take a moment just to consider Peter with Jesus. And this is in Matthew chapter 14. In this chapter, verses 30 and 32, a little bit before that, there is a big storm. Peter, James, John, the disciples, are all in a boat on the Sea of Galilee. Huge, huge storm, such that their boat is getting, you know, overwhelmed with waves and all this stuff. And Peter, James, and John are in the boat, and they looked up and they see Jesus walking on the water, right, in a big storm. This is weird. So, and it's nighttime, and this is the last thing they expect to see because Jesus was back at the, so they're like, what's going on here? And so they think it's a ghost. Literally in the Greek, they say it's a phantasm, a fantasy. And Peter says, and I love what Peter says, Lord, if it's you, bid me come. And I want you to appreciate that Peter knew Jesus, knew that if it was Jesus, Jesus always wants you close. Jesus always wants you connected, always wants you walking with him, regardless of what's happening around. And Peter knew, if it's a ghost, he's not going to tell me to come. But if it's Jesus, Jesus will always say, come. Jesus likes to have you close to him, no matter what's happening. And no matter where he is, even if he's walking on the water. And I appreciate that Peter got out of the boat, and Jesus said, come on, let's go. Let's take a walk. Which I think is just amazing. Like, okay, we're going to walk on the water. We don't do that. I mean, like, nobody's walked on. That's no. I mean, but Jesus says, come on. And I love what Peter did. He got out of the boat. All of those disciples were there. All of them could have walked on the water, but Peter's the only one that got out. Granted, when you read this chapter, when you read these verses, it's interesting because Peter says to him when he gets out, he sees the wind and he becomes frightened and he begins to sink. And he got distracted. He was walking to Jesus, walking alongside, but he started to look around at the wind and the waves. And I can appreciate what that means, because a lot of times in our lives we have windy seasons, we have stormy seasons, we kind of get, you know, a rude wake-up call with some kind of shock to the face or whatever, and we can get distracted by storms, by the winds, by the things that happen in our lives. And what happens is if we keep our eyes on Jesus, then we keep walking. But if we get distracted with the crisis or things that happen, shocking things in our lives, then we begin to sink. And that's what happened to Peter. He lost his focus on Jesus. Help, help, I'm drowning. He starts to sink into the Sea of Galilee. Jesus reaches out, grabs him and says, it's okay, I got you. And so no matter, maybe you've been sinking. Maybe you've been in a storm and you've been sinking. And this is just kind of a wake-up call. Hey, remember, come back to Jesus. Ask Jesus to help. Jesus can pull you out. Jesus can rescue you. Jesus can help you. You can recalibrate your focus to come back to Jesus. Get back dialed in on keeping him in your crosshairs. Because remember, where you focus is where you go. And your focus affects your decisions and your direction. So thank you so much for watching. Let's be like Peter, call out, hey, in the midst of a storm, hey, Jesus, help, help, I got distracted, please help. Recalibrate the focus. Let's come back on Jesus, back on track. And this book, Hey God, Can We Talk? This would be a helpful recalibration of focus. So get on the website, heygodbook.com. You can see how to order that there and be a huge, huge blessing, help you with your focus. And so when you finish watching this today, I want you to answer this question, and it's not related. It's a little bit unrelated. Think about this. What is your favorite book, author or TV, video, Netflix, YouTube thing that you watch? So either what you read or what you watch. Just answer that question for me. What's your favorite? And I just want to thank you for subscribing. Of course, hit the bells right there because notifications helps you know when we have new content. And finally, we need our joke, right? Here's your joke. What do you call a typo on a headstone, right? So like if you go to a graveyard, and you know, so a typo on a headstone is called a grave mistake. I know. You're like, pretty lame. Maybe, but next week will be way better. Thanks so much.